Hello, what's up, beautiful people? Thank you so much for stopping by to the Team Brian. If you're new to our channel, consider subscribing by clicking on that red subscribe button. If you're new to our channel, my name is Brian. Now you know me. Let's go. Now, yesterday we did a video about Qatar Airways starting their flights to Kenya on 15th June of 2020. And a lot of questions were raised, like people were asking a lot of questions. So I took time to do a research and really try to answer some of the questions based on the research that I did. So don't crucify me if I'm not going to answer your question the way you want it. But I believe like it's according to the research that I really tried to conduct. And I believe I've come up with a very positive answers to answer some of the questions that you asked. So stay tuned and we answer some of the questions that rose when everybody heard that the flights are going to be reopened. We are going to answer like three questions. The very first question I'll start with is, should I book my flight? That is somebody really asked on the comment section, like, should I book my flight? For me, I think it's too early, but if you are really prepared, yeah, you can start and book the flight, because if you check the website, it's already there, like on 15th, the flights are available to Kenya. So I believe if you book your flight, yeah, it's good, but if you really wait, I feel like the price tag is going to reduce, like the ticket price is going to reduce as day by day. So it's just like, give it a week or so, or we try and see like, is there any other next flight from the 15th so that you can book your flight. The second question I want to answer is, will I be compensated if I had booked a flight ticket before the pandemic? Yeah. I've read everywhere that you will be compensated if you had booked your flight earlier. Like you are in Kenya, of course there is no inbound flight, but if you were in Kenya before, you have booked a flight before the pandemic and they stopped, you're going to be compensated. I think, yeah, very sure you're going to be compensated. And my third question goes like, will I fly into Qatar? Like I was in Kenya, I left for vacation before the pandemic. Like, will I fly into Qatar? Unfortunately, no, there are no inbound flights, only outbound flight. Unless you're a Qatari, you can fly into Qatar. Or you are on transit, like you're going to other country via Qatar, you're allowed to come in Qatar, but you're not allowed to go outside the airport. So if you're outside, no inbound flights. Unfortunately, no inbound flights. So the third question that I was asked is, will I need to quarantine at the airport for 14 days? A lot of people are thinking like you're going to be quarantined at Hamad International Airport for another 14 days. No. When you're going to the airport has set cameras detecting the temperature of people around the airport. And you're required to produce like your medical report. That is like a medical certificate showing that you were tested and proved negative. And in case that you get symptoms, like the camera detects that your temperature is higher, you're going to be isolated in the airport clinics, being quarantined there and taken care of. So I believe like it's another very good measure. So clear that you're not going to be quarantined at the airport for another 14 days before you fly to your destination. No. That was a clear no, and we have really answered it well. Let's also try to clarify some of the things that may not be really allowed during this pandemic. Number one, if you're not going to fly, like if you don't have any travel destination, you're not allowed near the airport unless you're flying out. So don't make a mistake of going to the airport or taking your friend to the airport unless you are also flying out. Another thing also, many may ask like, are we the taxi drivers, like are we allowed to operate now near the airport? If you're dropping a guest, well and good. And picking, I think the airport now, taxis are going to do the work of picking people from the airport. Of course, there are no inbound flights, so definitely nobody is going to be picked from the airport. Only dropping people in the airport is going to be allowed. So really take notice, don't go to the airport and embarrass yourself, because it's really tight. The situation there is tight. There is tight security there, and people not allowed to mingle around at the airport. So, okay, I see, as we discussed yesterday, the flights are all way very expensive. Standing now at 70,000 Kenyan shillings, that's like 700 US dollars. So it's really way out expensive. And I've really tried to do a research, try to make communication that, are we going to quarantine ourselves for 2 weeks back in Kenya? For 14 days back in Kenya. And somebody said, no, it's really now you're going to quarantine yourself and you're going to be followed up. But if you really still want to quarantine using the government premises, that is like universities, hospitals, yeah, you're allowed to go. at your own cost, because I believe it's going to be expensive. The government has not still said or communicated that they're going to cater for the quarantine cost, but it's going to be way out at your own expenses. So I believe that we have answered some of the most critical questions that many were asking, and the date for flying is at 15th of June 2020, that is this year, that is like 5 days coming, the 15th of June. So get ready, get really, really ready for you to fly out if you really wanted, if you really been waiting for this, because I believe many, many people were waiting for this opportunity to fly back home. So yeah, it's good. And remember, you need the Ethereus app, you need to be tested before going to the airport. So really make arrangements as early as now, so that when it reaches time to fly, you don't get yourself, because it's never going to be the same. It's not really never going to be the same. Thank you so much for stopping by to the Team Brian again. If you're new to our channel, consider subscribing by clicking on that red subscribe button, and we're really going to appreciate. I really love you guys. Thank you so much for supporting me, and stay tuned. Thank you.